Doing episode 2 of our Crochet podcast. I want to thank everyone for coming back and joining me for another episode, and I am pleasantly surprised that the first one went over very well. So if you are a returning subscriber, thank you so much for joining me. And if you are a new viewer, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I hope you enjoy today's podcast. So, last time I was winging it, and this time I actually wrote stuff down. So, excuse me if I'm looking down a lot. So, today is February 28th, and one second. Okay, the time is 2:53 p.m. I was supposed to be recording this earlier, but alas, that did not happen, so I'm doing it now. And I want to start off by showing you all what I'm drinking. So today I have Stash's English Breakfast Tea, and I featured them in my previous podcast. Last time I believe I was drinking the peppermint tea, and I had this one, so I thought I would give it a try. Again, they are stationed in Portland, Oregon. They use only 100% natural ingredients, and this one has selected blended black teas in it. So I thought I'd give this one a try. And the mug is the same. This is my mom's mug. It's the Grand Canyon University mom mug that I got for her while I was at school. And for sweetener, I got some more. I will be using agave in the raw. It is vegan and naturally gluten-free. So this is what I'll be doing, and let's go ahead and mix up our tea. I've been letting this steep for about 5 minutes, and it's beautiful dark color. That's how I know it's done. So I'll just squeeze out that tea bag, set that aside, and let's go ahead and put in our agave. So today might be a short podcast. I don't really have much to show since last week, but today is Tuesday, so I did do some crocheting for a whole week. And let's mix our tea. I have actually never had English breakfast tea. This will be the first time that I'm having it. From Stash, I usually prefer the lemon ginger tea, and then the peppermint tea was really, really good, so I thought I would just try this one. And I got these from Winco. Let's go ahead and give it a try. Oh, that's really good. All right, I like that. Sorry if the camera moves. I'm using a like a little table, and then I have all my other stuff on the second table, so it's kind of hard to put the teacup on the second table. So if I'm picking it up and down and the camera's moving, that's why. Okay, so I want to get right into it because I have a lot of to talk about at the end after I show, well, not a lot, but I have some exciting news and then some updates to talk about towards the end. So let's go ahead and get into our works in progress. So last time I showed you some blankets that I had done. I did not work on any of those blankets at all, so it would be pointless for me to show those to you. But I did start one work in progress. I've really gotten into making sweaters. So I started a sweater for my brother, and he's heavily into anything about the army. And so I got this camouflage yarn, and I started a sweater for him. This is actually the second time I've done it, which is, I'm glad I'm bringing this up because I have to talk about this. So, I remember when I posted the tutorial for the easy crochet sweater, and I told you guys how to take the measurements. Well, I want to talk about that for a little bit, but this is as far as I've gotten on his This is the second time I've done it. So I want to talk about that for just a moment. So with the sweater, I told you that you take your waist measurement, divide it in half, and then chain that's your waist measurement divided in half, unstretched. So the issue with that is, for people like me and like my little brother, we like our clothes to be loose fitted, but fitted at the same time. Like, we like a lot of room. So I wanted to show you guys how to do that really quickly. So the easiest way to do that is, at first this was really fitting when I did it the first time and he did not like it. He said he wanted some room in his sweater so he could, you know, it'll be more comfortable for him. So what I did was I took one of his t-shirts and I just laid it on the bed, and then I started chaining, and then I would measure that chain against his t-shirt, and this is how I gave him the extra room that he wanted without it being overly too big, like the sweater that I had done for myself. So if you want your sweater to be like that, then that's what you can do. If you want it form-fitting, then of course, you know, keep it the same. And men's sweater, it's easier to make because they don't have a bust, but around the shoulders maybe you might want to do some increases. But if you do the sweater like I do it, the shoulder flaps are going to actually hang about right here, and you're going to have to create a neckline. And Tuesdays, since I wasn't able to see the girl I made the sweater for like a whole week, I wasn't able to film part two of the crochet sweater until today. And I plan on filming it today and uploading it today. So, and today is Tuesday, so you will see this on about Thursday. So, yeah, I just wanted to get that out the way. So if you are a woman, what I would recommend, because I haven't actually made one that was fitted to me, I've always made mine super oversized, but if you are a woman and you're doing it fitted, I would recommend to do some increases when you make the panel up to the bust. But remember, yarn does stretch. So even when you have your initial chain and you start crocheting along, it's gonna stretch out. So then you might have some grace period and you might be okay. But essentially, just do what fits best for you. And then I will show you how to do the neckline when I post the crochet tutorial part two. And I also plan on doing a little info video, because this is just, it's quite trial and error. It's always easier to make something for a little child than it is for an adult. But as I'm doing this more and crocheting more, I'm learning this, and I would love to share it with you all and to make sure that you all know what I know. So yeah, I do plan on posting like a little easy crochet sweater Q&A on how to do it for bigger people. But the video I posted for the toddler size is perfectly fine. Okay, so yeah, that's the sweater that I started for my brother. And then I have a really exciting whip. This is the knitted blanket that I was doing. And let me grab it really quickly. Sorry for my creaky chair. But yeah, so I've made a lot of progress on this blanket. I have been knitting it more than I've actually been working on all my other works in progress. So if you can remember from the last video, it's gotten substantially longer. I'm in the middle of knitting right now, but I am so proud of myself. I told myself I was actually gonna start working on it, hair, and I did. So I hopefully, you know, as I keep doing this, these podcasts, it's really holding me accountable for, you know, actually knitting and crocheting. So I'm super duper excited about that. And I've also almost mastered the art of not knitting backwards, because like I stated before, that was a big issue of mine. I would put the project down for a long time, and then when I would pick it up, I would accidentally knit backwards. But It's been a week now and I have not had that issue no matter how many times I put it down. And I'm really happy that I've actually gotten faster at knitting. I don't feel it's mindless. Well, doing garter stitch is mindless for me now. And it makes me want to work on it more. So those are some happy developments that I've made. And I cut my fingers. I have a Band-Aid. And it's really come in handy because one thing I always hated was because I push the needle with my finger out. And it always like hurts because I even push it with my thumb. So I'm going to try to invest in like some like, I don't want to just use up Band-Aids, but I'm going to figure something out because I don't like the way it feels when the needle like hits my the tip of my fingers for a long time. So yeah, but yeah, this I'm really really proud of myself. My goal was to get better at knitting, and I think that the more I'm doing it, I'm getting better. I don't think I'm ready to tackle socks yet. I did try to do the magic loop, and a super duper nice lady, she gave me this tutorial on how to do socks, and I plan on practicing that one because I haven't really found beginner friendly YouTube videos. So that was my issue with that. So yeah, I'm trying to hurry up and finish this row so I can give you guys a better picture of what it actually looks like. And then I, because my long-term goal is really socks, to have a lot of knitted socks, because I really want to do 1 year, do the Box O Socks Cow, that Bad Wolf Girl Sits and Knits does. So yeah, and then maybe like if I'm like good enough, I'll even want to do cardigans. I see a lot of knitters, they're knitted cardigans, and it's really beautiful. And I want some garments of my own. And here's my last stitch. And I have a free needle. And this is what it's looking like so far. It's gotten so much longer than last time. Still has holes galore, but that's okay. Like I said last time, sorry about my chair, it's like really old. That's okay. The holes don't bother me. So yeah, that's that. Okay, and then the last work in progress that I have is the sweater. I finished one sleeve. I actually had her try it on. Oh my gosh, she loves it and she looks so cute in it. I have this sleeve. And then I started working on the other sleeve, but I have to rip this one out because I did it wrong. Because I never write anything down and I make mistakes. So I have to rip this sleeve out, but this one's finished. It's actually inside out. And then, since like I stated previously, the shoulder flaps actually fall here, like around here, I'm going to show you guys how to do the neckline. And that'll be in the second video, but that's what this looks like. So yeah, it's really hard to work on this because I constantly need her to try it on, but it fits her perfectly. I mean, it's really long, so if she wears some cute little leggings, she could wear it as a dress. And then another thing about the sweater is it's really loose up here. So also in the video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to decrease to make it fit better. So it's really hard to do stuff like that because I constantly need her to try it on so I can see it fits, and I only see her once a week. So I'm going to show you guys how to do it, but mine won't probably be done by the time yours is done. That's okay. Oh, that's really good. So yeah, those are my whips for the week. And now we can move on to finished objects. I have one finished object because I, like I said, I didn't work on any of the whips I showed in the first podcast, but I have one finished object. And I'm super excited. I love this. I consider it a finished object because it's done, but there's some things that I plan to make changes with. But at my church, we had the Black History Month Day, and what we were supposed to do was wear African attire, but I didn't have any. So what I decided to do was take the colors of the African flag, and I crocheted a sweater. And this is it. It's made smaller than my first one. I used less chains. The first one was 100 chains. This one was only 90. And it came out way better than the first one. Of course, it's still too big. But other than that, it came out better. So this is what that one's looking like. And I didn't put long sleeves. I just kept it short sleeved. It was really pretty. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make it longer because one issue that I have with this is that, look, I didn't even, it was so, I finished it the Sunday morning. I didn't weave in any hint. But I'm gonna make it longer and make it like a little dress because it's so, because like, with sweaters you need them to be rectangle, and right now, like this way, I didn't do enough rows, so it's boxy. But if I make it longer, that'll balance it out. And it's the same off the shoulder design, but it's a little too much off the shoulder, so I plan on decreasing some more and fixing that. Yeah, I love this. I love it. I love it. I love it. What else? Yeah, and I'm gonna do an info video on how to basically, like, you know, if you wanna do the measuring, if you wanna do it exactly like this and have it like a cute off the shoulder, I call it old school sweater. Well, more like a boyfriend sweater. I like how big it is. Like, let me put it on. So yeah, I like how big it is. I'm not really a person who's into fitted sweaters and stuff. It's, you see how it's off the shoulder. I know I'm a little too, like, too close, but let me move my chair. This is the back. It's long. Let me scoot it in. So yeah, that's the back. And this is what it looks like from the front. I don't know if you guys can see this. But yeah, I like the way this looks. I'm really into this style. But if you're not, definitely don't make it as big as this. But if you want it this big and you want me to put up a tutorial for that, just let me know. This is what it looks like on. Excuse me, I have to use my yarn back. Move my yarn back. So yeah, that's what this sweater looks like. I love it. I love it, I love it, I love it. And of course it has dog hair on it. You know, you love animals so much, it's what you have to deal with. So yeah, this is my only finished object for the week. And it's actually pretty hot in my room, so I'm not gonna wear this. I was gonna wear it, but no. My chair is so squeaky. Okay. So that's that. I do plan on crocheting more, but we are moving, so I'm packing everything and it's been really stressful. So yeah. Okay, so that was my only finished object. Now this, I can't really call this section like dream crocheting for the simple fact like that this is something that I have to do. Like, I don't have a choice. But I'm making an outfit for my best friend. She's turning 21 in May. And I am crocheting her a dress. So I need to, I already have the pattern thought out. I already have like how I'm gonna execute it, what yarn I'm gonna use. I just have to go buy it. So that falls under the dream crochet, I think. And then I made up in my mind to promote myself more. That I was gonna crochet one garment a week to wear to church. And it's also so that I can start filling my closet with like a bunch of crocheted stuff. So I plan on crocheting a dress. I found a pattern, but I didn't really like it. So what I decided to do was like just wing it and just make it up myself. And if I like it and if it comes out very well, I'll post a tutorial on how to do it. I have it like all in my head. And once I work it on my head, I'm going to write it down in my pattern book. So yeah, those are the two things that I'm going to crochet. Like, they're not dream crochet because it's actually going to happen. So it's more like I'm going to do it crochet. And I need to start on my dress. I have time for my friend's dress. I'm going to start hers in April, but I need to... Sorry, I'm like shaking the camera. It's my notes. I have to start on mine ASAP. And mine is a scrap buster project. So it's going to be very interesting. And I will keep you guys posted. You should... If you want to see updates on that project, go ahead to my Instagram. And it's... The_CO. So the_CO. And that's my Instagram, and you'll be able to see all the updates for that. So yeah, this is a super fast podcast because I haven't really done much this week. I don't have any stash enhancements. I haven't bought any yarn. I'm the type that'll buy yarn and not have a purpose for it. So I have like all this yarn that I don't need. So I'm not buying any more yarn until I get rid of a good chunk of what I have. I have too much. So that's why I don't have any stash enhancements. What else? I think that's it. So this is going to be called the anything else section. This is the part of the podcast that doesn't really tie into what I was speaking on before. I have been really blessed with this YouTube channel and the amount of people that are coming and watching my content and really appreciate everything that I'm putting out. So last night I went to bed and I was just checking my videos and, you know, replying to comments, and I saw I had 40 subscribers and I'm like, whoa, like, you know, that's big for me because I've had this channel for a while and it's just been crazy that, you know, it's just like in 2 weeks I went from like 19, well, not 2 weeks, that's an exaggeration, but like, I don't know, it's just every time I go on my channel I have like new subscribers, and it's like crazy to me that people actually care about what I'm saying. So I went to bed and I had 40, it was at 39 earlier in the day, and I was like, yeah. So then I wake up and it's like I had these emails of new comments, and then I was like, wow. So I replied to the comments, and then I was watching YouTube, and then when I watch YouTube I always go to my channel and just check, and then I saw I had 5 new subscribers. That's like in one day, one night actually, because I went to bed at like 12 a.m. Nevada time, so Pacific time, and I was like, holy crap, like I'm 5 people away from having 50 subscribers, and I thought that was super duper crazy. And I'm thinking of like to show my appreciation doing a giveaway. So I think, I don't know if I want to do a 50 subscriber giveaway or wait till I reach like the 100 subscriber milestone. I'm not too sure like what's the best way, but you guys tell me what you think that I should do, if I should do the 50 or wait till I get to 100. And then I'm not too sure as to what I want to do to show my appreciation. I really want to make something for someone, so whoever wins, I really want to make you something. And I know a majority of you guys might already be crocheters, but you know, there's nothing more special than a handmade item. So that's what I'm thinking of doing. I'm not too sure at the moment, but I will think on it more and I will definitely get back to you guys on that. Also, I wanted to go over, sorry if you can hear talking, it's the walls are super thin here and I'm in my room. I also wanted to go over my filming schedule. So what I found out works best for me is to film on Tuesdays and upload on Thursdays. So that means I will be uploading, filming podcasts on Tuesdays, and they'll be uploaded either, that's what I'm having an issue with. Tuesday and Thursday are like the best times for me to upload because Wednesday is when I can, when I can dedicate the day to actually editing the videos. So I'm thinking I'm gonna do that. Tuesdays, filming and uploads on Thursdays. So that means you might get two videos in one day, or I'll maybe the video that takes the less time, I'll upload on Wednesday. So that might actually be a tutorial. So yeah, I think that's what I'll exactly what I'll do. I'll film podcasts on Tuesdays and I'll upload them on Thursday because they take the most time to edit, because you know sometimes they're like an hour long, but when it comes to tutorials and other videos, I can still film on Tuesday and upload on Wednesday. So you'll get two videos a week. Don't quote me on that, but you'll definitely be getting a podcast a week. So yeah, that's all I wanted to talk about in the anything else category. I really, really enjoy these podcasts and I'm so happy that you guys enjoy them too. And I hope that you're having a cup of tea with me and crocheting while you listen, because that's what I love to do with podcasts. If you have any questions for me or any tutorials that you want to see, feel free to comment below. I do have the plus size crochet playlist on my channel, so go ahead and check that out. I have a lot of things in the works for that playlist, but I don't want to say them right now. So I'm perfecting a lot of things when it comes to my plus size crochet playlist, so please go ahead and check that out. And it's almost summer, sorry my leg is itchy. It's almost summer, so make sure you make your top, your crocheted top. What else? I don't know. I think for today, I think that's all. I do plan on crocheting more and having more to show you guys next week. I want to thank all my new subscribers and all my old subscribers for joining me again this week. Oh, there's Thor. That's our Ruru. He doesn't bark. He kind of like yells. But yeah, he's so cute. I plan on... It's super duper loud. Okay, I'm just gonna end it here. Okay, thank you guys for coming back to my channel. I hope you enjoyed this video. I love you guys so much, and I'll see you in the next one.